Okay, if I saw Michael today, what would I ask him? I would ask him if he really loved me.
I started my career at the age of 15 in Tokyo. I sang, danced, and modeled, did high fashion modeling there. And that's where my career began.
My agent over in Japan told me if I wanted to get back into the business, maybe I should go to Playboy. He said because I was too short to become a high fashion model because I'm only 5'4". And so he said, you know, to get back into the business, it would be best probably to go to Playboy. And I walked into the Playboy building. It was on Sunset Boulevard at the time.
And with my pictures in my hand, sat it down and told them who I was and that I wanted to see if I can audition and become a centerfold for Playboy. And they called me like within the next week. And they said, well, yeah, come on in. And after that, I became a June centerfold, 1980.
In the Playboy magazine, they asked me who was one of my most favorite artists in the world, and I had put his name. So I've been a longtime fan of his.
I had been sent out on an interview to see John Landis. The director of Thriller. And once I got into his office, he started explaining to me about how he needed a girl who was going to be the girlfriend of a guy who turns into a werewolf.
And I went in and he started telling me about Michael's video. And
then he started to play the Thriller song. And I kind of looked at him and I'm like, oh my God, are you serious? Are you talking about Michael Jackson?
Wow, so he didn't tell you until the song?
No, he didn't.
And I had this huge grin on my face, you know, I just stared at the John Landis and had this grin on my face like, oh, you gotta give it to me. I would love to do it.
Yeah.
And he said, okay, well, let me think about it. And he said, let me talk to Michael.
Did Michael ever see your pictorial?
Yes.
He did, and what did he say?
I think what had happened is John had saw me in the Playboy magazine, and I think he kind of like, you know, took
the
picture.
He liked what he saw.
He took the picture to Michael.
That is so,
and,
that is so funny.
Michael agreed to for me to do the role.
I couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe it. Out of all the women in the world, that I was chosen.
The first night I went on the set was the day that they were shooting the actual Thriller dance. So this is the night Michael was like saying, over, let's do it again, let's do it again, let's do it again. And each time they did it, they were on point. So I don't know how many weeks it took them to do it, but they did a great job.
I had a front row seat and they danced in front and I got to watch perfection. That's what I got to watch. Michael just kept saying again. And again, I mean, and again, and every time he said it, they just went back into place, and they just started dropping it, and they was doing their thing. It was great.
Did you see Michael for the first time?
For the first time, I saw him in the dressing room.
Oh. And then he's coming in, and
yeah,
says,
and I just kind of, hi,
Michael.
I'm Michael.
Yeah? And you melted?
A little bit.
No, were you excited to see
him? Yeah, I was very excited.
Yes, this is where I first met Michael. He had sent a limo to pick me up that night. I was really nervous that night. So a friend of mine was at my house and was like saying they were smoking pot. And I don't smoke weed. And he was like, take a puff off of this. He said, that'll relax you a little bit. And I'm like, okay. I took a puff off of it. By the time I got here, I was like so high. Because, you know, when you don't smoke weed, one puff will do you. And so Michael, when he gave me a hug and kiss and everything, he looked at me and he said, have you been smoking weed? And I said, no. And he said, do you smoke weed?
What?
And I said, no, I said, Michael, I'm so sorry. I said, somebody was at my house and they told me if I took a puff, that would help me relax a little bit. And I said, but I'm sorry, I really don't smoke weed. And he looked at me and he started laughing so loud.
He loved to tell jokes. He's fun to be around. He's always telling jokes and trying to make you laugh.
He's always tickling my feet, trying to make me laugh. I mean, we had so much fun. He would get really into character once he put that werewolf outfit on. He was always jumping out behind doors trying to scare me.
Michael Jackson isn't Michael Jackson as a werewolf. Michael Jackson is another person totally with the mask.
He was going, we were looking at the scene and he was telling John, because I was screaming so loud and so much, and he's like, John, are we going to keep her scream in the whole time? And Michael was saying, yes. You know, I mean, John was saying, yes, we're going to keep it in. He's like, oh, okay.
It was crazy. It was like you see down there where that car is.
Yeah.
They had it blocked off, and there were like hundreds of people down there. Michael and I would come out and wave at them, and they would just scream their heads off.
And Michael would run out, and the fans would see him, and they would scream, and they would be so happy. And then Michael would push me out. He's like, okay, it's your turn. And I would go out there, and they were like all quiet. Nobody would say anything. And then Michael would laugh at me, and he said, it's okay. He said, they're going to know who you are, sure enough, one day.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I felt like I was the most luckiest girl in the world.
Wow.
I had Michael singing and dancing around me while I did my little thriller walk.
Okay, so before we did the scene, I asked Michael. I'm like, so, Michael, what do you want me to do? Where do you want me to kiss you? And he said, well, where do you want to kiss me? And I said, well, I don't know yet. And he said, I said, well, you can kiss me wherever you like.
So I said to him, I don't know yet. And so when they said action, I just reached up and kissed him on his cheek. But yes, there is definitely a second kiss, but you guys, it was behind closed doors.
What point did you realize you were falling in love with him?
When we did the dancing, when he had to walk around me and flirt with me. Just coming from out of the movie theaters, when we did I did a little walk, dun, 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 to the beat. And he had to dance around me and flirt with me. That was when I was like, oh my God. It's like, Ola, you know, I could not believe I was the girl. I was the one chosen.
Yeah, there was a second kiss and a lot more.
Were you ever intimate with Michael Jackson?
No, I wasn't intimate with him, but we did have our intimate moments together. You know, we spent a lot of time talking and, you know, sharing different things. But no, it's nothing like that, even though maybe I would like to have it have been, but no. I think at the time he was into Brooke Shields. He kept playing with me and teasing me. It's like, Brooke Shields here? And I was like, Sam, well, I don't care. You know, I really didn't want to know that, but.
When did you tell him that you were in love with him?
Mm-mm. I didn't tell him. And that's one thing, you know. I hate the fact that I didn't get a chance to really tell him how I felt about him.
You don't have contact anymore with Michael, or?
No. I saw him a couple of times after that in the studios, because I'm also recording. But no, I haven't seen him.
Together, I was working on my music, and he was there in the same studio working on his. So I went over to him and kissed him and gave him a hug.
We were supposed to have a secret rendezvous. A friend of the family's had contacted me, and we were supposed to meet in Vegas, but it never happened.
He sent me to Germany to go pick up our Grammy. He wanted to come pick it up, but he was going to send someone else to come pick it up. And I told him, no, if you don't come pick it up yourself, you know, you're not going to get it. So he didn't come get it. So he called and told me that it was mine. I can keep that one. So I, to this day, do have one of the Grammys.
Mega success of the thriller video, life became a real-life horror story for Ola.
After Thriller being so big, I had a lot of people always coming over to my house. And that is kind of what started it.
I had to move because there were too many people calling me and too many people knocking on my door. It frightened me because it was so big. You know, I just thought I was doing a video. I didn't realize that it was going to be that blown out of proportion. I thought that I would get more jobs doing other things, but it wasn't so. I just went into a slump and I got really depressed. So I personally went through a whole slew of things.
A few hours ago, cops gave the signal to begin a lightning raid on a suspected LA drug den. By the time the daring operation was over, the star of one of the biggest music videos of all time was behind bars.
But yesterday, that luck seems to have run out for Ola Ray. And today, the magical world of music videos and Michael Jackson seems to be light years away. Ola's newest project, as the star of this exclusive amateur video, seems to be one more example of Hollywood's chain of broken dreams, and a reminder that too often, happy endings occur only in the movies.
The drug bust at my house. I was using, what people don't know about that, and I talk about it in my book, I was dating an undercover cop. I didn't know it at the time. I found out after I came out of jail. And he did that to me and called the television station and had them sitting there when I came out with handcuffs. And so it was a fake arrest. I never did any prison time. And all that stuff about me being Miss Drug Pen or whatever, King Pen woman, I mean, that was all meth. That was all crazy. But so my life had been exposed, first of all, me using. And then another thing for them to lie about all that they said happened to me, it was devastating.
Michael Jackson's screen girlfriend is suing the singer for more money. According to press reports, 13 years after acting alongside Jackson in the Thriller video, Ola Ray has decided she didn't get paid enough for her role and wants some of the royalties of the sales of the groundbreaking video.
When I see the Thriller video today, I get very angry because I have to look at this video and I have to think to myself, well, I won't be getting a residual check from it. The only relationship I have with Michael is me trying to get my lawyer to contact him to try to get him to pay me my money.
It's when I hear Thriller, for me, it's not, it doesn't take me to a very happy place. I'm going to be very honest with you. I've had to go through a lot, you know, and you know, dealing with the situations without me getting my royalties, and so for me it was painful for me to even see the video, because it was like, okay, here we go, Halloween is coming around again, they're gonna show it every day. And so for me it was really hard to see my work on the screen and to know that I'm not gonna receive a royalty from it.
I got a knock at the door. I'm like, who are you? And
right,
they're like, you know, turn the TV on and here's my card. And they slipped a card underneath the door and it was a news crew. And so I went and I turned my television on and then I saw what had happened and I immediately went into shock. I was just like so devastated.
You know? I was so shocked and I was like, I couldn't speak when I was first told this information. And I started screaming, you know, just like, no way, you know, I can't do it. I'm in disbelief, you know, and I cannot believe he's gone. I cannot believe that Michael's gone. There's no way I can even imagine. I keep going to sleep and thinking, when, you know, I'm gonna wake up and he's gonna be here. I'm thinking it's all a dream right now. He took me on a total spiritual journey with him after he passed away. 3 days after he passed away, he came to me and in my dreams, and pretty much after that, he showed me every level of consciousness that he went through with his passing, from the beginning of him being in denial to where he felt like his spiritual resting would be. And then from there, with him in heaven, showing me his house that he's living in now.
Thriller? Is Thriller your favorite MJ song?
No.
What? What? Okay, what is it?
No, my favorite Michael Jackson song is Remember.
Remember the Time?
Remember the Time. I kind of feel like he wrote that for us.
In what way did it change your life to be in the Michael Jackson?
Well, I can't go anywhere without people recognizing me.
You know? Still?
Yeah.
After all these years?
Yeah, definitely. So I do have the fame and glory. It's not the fortune.
She has a lot of respect for the man she says made her a part of history.
I didn't know that I was going to be a part of history, but that's the way it turned out.
When I think of Michael, I think of innocence. I think of love. I think of a very brilliant performer and his love for passion and for his love of music and dance.
I want people to remember him thinking that, you know, this was God's gift to us, you know, and we should celebrate the fact that we even had a short time to spend with him, you know, and we should be grateful for everything that he gave to us, you know.